Welcome to the video news of the week. A group of Canadian firms are visiting North Country towns today, with locals hoping that the day will introduce them to the merits of expanding into the North Country. Hosted by the New Hampshire Division of Resources and Economic Development, representatives of three Canadian companies began their North Country tour by arriving on Thursday night at the Balsams Grand Resort Hotel in Dixville Notch. Colebrook is making a concentrated effort to welcome them to town this morning, with a presentation at the Business Park. Earlier this week, we stopped by Lin Jo Creations in Colebrook, where Key Club students were working on signs which will help welcome the visitors. We spoke with Colebrook Development Corporation President Mark Nugent about the visit.
They are putting together a new industrial park sign, or business park sign, that Colebrook Development Corp owns the property down on Bill Bromage Drive. And we're just updating it, making it cleaner, repainting it, and for our visit that we have with these three Canadian firms coming to Colebrook on Friday. Personally, with the Colebrook Development Corp, we'll be speaking in regards to the foreign trade zone that Colebrook offers to Canadian companies, which is just an extension from Quebec into New Hampshire. We'll be also talking about municipality services, the schools, how Colebrook Academy is actually bronze medal winner for U.S. News and World Reports, just trying to give them the overall feel of what Colebrook offers other than just professional business, but what their families will be able to become a part of when they come to Colebrook. What we have all planned for them is we've worked with the Coalition of Colebrook. We've also worked with UCVH, the Health Center, Rec Center, and what have you, coming together and actually putting together a presentation down on Friday morning at roughly 9:30 to 10 o'clock at off Bill Bromage Drive at the Colebrook Manufacturing Building, and just presenting to them everything of what Colebrook offers. The economic feel we have in Colebrook has been a little bit suppressed as of late, obviously, and to be able to have the attempt and ability to work with Dread, to have these companies come to Colebrook and be able to say, hey, you know what? This is what we have to offer. And I feel very proud of what we were able to do to get that done.
Colebrook Elementary School's annual carnival brought a large crowd of youngsters to the school's parking lot where many activities were hosted. Later that evening, the Colebrook Academy students marched down Main Street showing Mohawk pride during the homecoming parade.
Crabapple Downs in Columbia hosted its annual poodle party last Saturday. Chronicle reporter Liz Carney was there to capture some of the show and fun.
It was a busy weekend in Stratford. It got underway on the Common with Festive Fridays, featuring basket weaver Linda Lomasley.
So right now I am weaving an open bottom base, and I'm just measuring it to square it up to the size of the handle.
Oh my God.
Wow. All right.
The following day saw the Fall Fest with more crafts, music, and plenty of scarecrows.
Often prayed in the darkness of my night.
The Colebrook Chronicle traveled to Lincoln this past weekend for the popular New Hampshire Highland Games. Here is our report. The Colebrook Chronicle visits the New Hampshire Highland Games here in Lincoln, New Hampshire, where there's plenty of competition going on in back of me right now. And there's also some great music, some great dance, some great food, and everything Celtic.
of the many attractions at the Highland Games is the Clan Village, where people can come and visit tents representing each Scottish clan. Cindy Lindstrand sent us this photo showing corn being chopped on the last day of summer at the Grey Mist Farm in Groveton. Friday, scattered thunderstorms move into the area as the temperature reaches a high of 71 and a low of 59. Saturday dips down to 64 and a low of 47. And Sunday brings in the clouds as the temps range from 59 to 44. Chronicle reporter Liz Carney captured this video of the homecoming match between Colebrook and Groveton.
Now Sedwick make a run! Look at it! It's Josie in the gap! Pressure!
Hey, now we gotta get back!
Come on, Richard! The Colebrook teams won both of the matches. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.